London space elevator. From biblical times, people had dreamt of a stairway to heaven, a means of simply climbing into space. 25 years ago, this became a reality here in London. Our planet, the Earth, has finite resource and capability, and climate change has taken its toll. Our only chance of long-term survival is to spread outwards into space. The London Space Elevator was and is the first step of man's journey in this exploration. As can be seen, the Shoebury Ness area has become a plethora of concrete warehouses and all the associated buildings, and acts as the transport base to feed the space elevator with people and, of course, cargo. The Shoebury Ness transport hub is connected to the large, permanent and stationary receiving platform via a high-speed dual monorail system. The elevator base itself is in effect a large, complex and movable entity akin to a massive ship, and docks into the fixed platform. This movement capability of the elevator base is necessary to prevent potential damage to the space tether itself. The stationary platform houses a large conglomeration of intrinsically articulated zones, including port facilities, travel centers, security, accommodation, and technical control. The elevator base is a very large entity, is fully mobile and minutely maneuverable to facilitate its permanent tether arrangement with the spaceport. This facility enables it to dock with the fixed permanent platform. It is, of course, the main departure point between this planet and space itself, and houses complex and vulnerable components, and is therefore subject to extremely high security arrangements. It is unique and an astounding monument to man's intent to explore and expand into space. The whole edifice is controlled from a central tower arrangement which provides direct connectivity and direction to all key areas and is set apart from the rest of the structure due to its sensitivity to security issues and the complex systems housed there. The western edge of the platform houses the port, production and research centres, particularly regarding energy harnessing. Today, we have been allowed to use a sophisticated drone to view a number of normally restricted zones to further see the size and complexity of this major engineering development. The warehousing and storage facilities for the thousands of people that are working within the project are immense and added to almost on a monthly basis. The permanent dock also houses, deep within its central core, quarantine zones, research and development laboratories, and testing facilities. Some of the best scientists in the world work here, ensuring the safety and protection of space products and materials, and acting as a barrier to prevent cross-contamination. The maintenance and safety of both the dock and the elevator are by definition complex systems in their own right. Many aspects are not available to human intervention, and the artificial intelligence, self-managing, robotic mechanical devices are an important aspect. The London Space Elevator also provides access to the general public to view its energy recovery and space exploration facets, and it also provides exhibition centres and accommodation for visitors and space travellers. This view of the mobile base station illustrates its high degree of manoeuvrability and the vertical rail system terminal, which of course travels 36,000 kilometres to the spaceport. Capable of great speed and driven by magnetic levitation and propulsion, the journey takes between 0.7 and 1.2 days, dependent upon the payload. Earth orbit platform provides the most dramatic and memorable experience currently available to any visitor. The journey to this point takes just 4 hours only. People returning from the viewing platform describe it as opening a completely new vista on life and humanity's place within it. The blue planet is obviously clearly visible, but for the first time seen by many as the extraordinary creation it really is. At 36,000 kilometers, your train enters the spaceport. In time, this will be the size and have the capability and facilities of a small town. Large craft can be constructed here, and in a weightless environment can simply be pushed into orbit. A seemingly impossible action, but now happening almost on a monthly basis.
Upon returning to Earth, many astronauts and visitors have reported experiencing a phenomenon known as the overview effect. This is an overwhelming feeling of seeing the Earth as one and the fragility of the web of life. Many have conveyed feelings of spiritual oneness with the universe and a new concern for humanity. With the easier access that the space elevator creates, more and more people experiencing this may help trigger humanity's evolution to a higher state of consciousness. We can only hope this is true.